There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there.
All right. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Hi, hi. There's our team. Look at everybody. Smiling faces. Happy Monday and welcome to Diamond Zone. I hope everybody had a great weekend. We had a great call last night, Sunday night. And once again, we'll have another one tonight, Monday night, 6 o'clock Pacific time. So please make sure, guys, you are promoting that next event. That's how we all make money, right? So with that said, want to make sure everybody knows, hang on, let's do this. Looks like 4 weeks from today, we're going early. So 4 weeks from today, we'll be in Las Vegas, guys. So the Las Vegas Diamond Life Convention, you do not want to miss this event. You got to figure out how to get there. Many, many big announcements will be made at this event. And we know this event will set up 2018 in a very, very, very big way. You know, a lot of people are saying that with what they're going to be announcing is going to create, you know, tremendous momentum for our company. And, you know, I'm of the mindset that, you know, if we're excited every single day, we don't need to keep being motivated. Okay? I'm motivated every day I wake up. And that's why we do Diamond Zone. Okay, we want to make sure, okay, it's not because we have a new product or because we have a new launch. Those are great. Okay, but I think everybody needs to be motivated day one. Okay, every day you wake up, if your why is big enough, okay, you don't need all this other stuff to keep you motivated. It's got to be consistent motivation. Because here's my belief. And maybe some of you guys will disagree with my belief or not, but it really makes no difference. Okay. My belief is this. Okay. If you could be motivated, you could be demotivated. Okay. Right. If you could get up, you could get down. It's the person who wins is the one that stays even. Okay. They're not affected. Okay. By a good day or a bad day. And I understand you got to find your little successes. I get it. Of course. Like, for example, Jenny, okay, she gets on the call today. She's all excited because she signed somebody new up. Absolutely. Okay, you want to change your attitude? Get one new recruit. Okay, there's no doubt about that. That does motivate you. But I do say this. Okay, if you know where you're going, okay, it's just the journey, right? It's the climb. It's all the things that you deal with on a daily basis. But you know what? If something doesn't go your way, what happens? Nothing. I keep moving forward. If something does go good your way, what do? You keep moving forward. Okay? It's all about your attitude. That's always what it's always about. And who controls your attitude? You do. You do. And if you're focused in, okay, on all the things that you could have with this business, you stay motivated. God knows I'm challenged on a daily basis. I'm challenged because you know why? I get all the calls from you, okay? And we got to be the piece. See, who motivates the motivator? Think about that. Who motivates the motivator? Okay, you got to be the motivator. You got to be the desire that a lot of people lack. That's what leadership is. Leadership never shows a chink in their armor, okay? And people buy into that belief. And so what I want to do today, guys, is I want to just really share with you, you know, and a lot of you have seen the different trainings because sometimes we repeat them. Well, not sometimes. It's the trainings are the trainings. But if you're taking the journey, I promise you, you listen to the trainings differently. It's how it affects you. Okay, you may have saw this training 3 months ago, but because you're a different person, you will hear it differently. And here's what I want you all to do. I want you to listen to the trainings, Okay. And ask yourself, does this apply to me first? Because the only person you can really control is you. You can't control your downline. You can motivate, right? You could be the belief system, but you can't control others. People are either motivated or they're not. So just ask yourself, does this affect me? Am I in this place? And then ask yourself, who in my group can I identify and maybe help them get them out of this place? Okay, that's what I want you to do, is just listen to the training, okay, first and foremost for you. Okay, now, the training I want to do today, where am I going here? I'm going to screen share, right? I think I'd have this down by now, right? All right, can you guys see my screen? I think you can, right? Cancel, click, cancel. Why is that doing that? Hang with me. Why can't I close this? Okay, there we go. All right. Where is it? There it is. All right. So the training I'm going to do today, guys, is all the things, okay, that could derail you within this business. Because you know there's certain things you can do to build your business, right? We all know that. There's certain things you can do to build your business. But there's things that will derail your business. We call them pitfalls, okay? That's a nice word. I call them landmines, basically what I call them, because these are the things that will blow up the average person. But what I like to add to this is how to correct them, okay? And the way you correct them is first to identify and being honest with yourself if you're in a landmine. Because if you're in a landmine and that landmine goes off, it's going to blow off a couple of legs. Okay, you might lose an arm. Okay, and that's part of the journey. That's part of the climb. It's not whether or not you hit one. It's how you react when you hit one. Okay, so let me go through some of these guys. But first of all, what I want everybody to know, and I really believe this, every time I bring in a person, I see unlimited potential. Now, what's potential? Okay, potential, I believe everybody can do this. That's my belief system. Let me ask you, do you believe everybody can do our program? Okay, you gotta ask yourself, do you believe in it? Because if you don't believe everybody can do it, okay, you're gonna be very hesitant to talk to people. But here's where a lot of people miss it. Okay, I don't want people, let's say you're not getting the results that you wanna get. Okay, first of all, you got to have realistic expectations, and that's a whole nother training. Okay, we'll do that later this week. Okay, but you have to believe, regardless of the results you're getting, that other people are getting the results. Because potential is overrated without action. I think everybody has potential. Everybody on this call, without a doubt, and let's just use the basic, let's just use diamond. Okay, I believe everybody on this call has the potential to hit diamond. Everybody. Okay, but what does it take? It takes consistent action. Consistent action. Now, let's talk about action for a second. Did you guys see my Facebook post that I did promoting last night's event? Okay, it's a question. I want people to get really good at collecting decisions. And what you got to do, you got to ask directly people this question. Do you keep your business options open? Do you keep your money-making opportunities open? And that starts a conversation. You have to be direct, and you got to get a yes or no. You got to collect that decision. That's the action you have to take. Okay, it's not all this fluff. It's a real simple question. Anne Marie, do you keep your business options open? Yes or no? Perfect. Great. I found something. I would love you to check this out because this is something I really believe is going to be very big. And now you start the process. We're trying to think of the magic phrase to say the action is real simple. Okay. Do you keep your business options open? Or money-making opportunities open, whatever you want to say. You got to collect that decision. You got to pick up the phone and you got to get and ask 100 people, and you got to collect that decision. If they say yes, lead them to the information. Now, do you believe in that direction? Because if you don't believe in the direction the company gives you, hey, you'll never take action. And then I promise you, if you collect, if you get a 50 to 100, let's just say 100. If you get 100 people to answer that question, I don't care if it's a yes or no. There's going to be a percentage of yeses. And from the percentage of yeses, then, okay, you're going to get people taking the journey of receiving the information. And I promise you, there's going to be some result. Now, let me ask you this. If someone says no, okay, what do you say to that person? If someone tells me no, you know what I say? Perfect. Are you open to understanding what I'm doing? So just in case you do come across somebody that's open, you can lead them to me. Okay, what are they going to say? Say no again? Okay. But you know what, guys? I just want soldiers out there getting the information into people's hands. That's all I want. I want an army of soldiers talking about World Global Network. And I just want to make sure, okay, that their experience is a positive one. Because if someone saw the two-minute video, let's just use the two-minute video for example. Don't you think they have a little bit more belief in what you're doing? They might not be for them, but you know how many times I've had people, okay, that say no to me, but somebody else would call me because of that referral? Okay, and we talk about this all the time. So I believe everybody has unlimited potential here, okay? So you got to believe that. But what separates is always the action. Let's talk about that. Because here's what keeps people stuck. Action, it sounds easy, but unless your desire and your why is big enough, you're never going to take action. Because I will tell you, this is where the fear comes in. See, fear doesn't go away when people make the decision. Fear just begins. Okay, if you got them past the fear of signing up, great. That's a first step. Okay, but that doesn't mean, okay, that other voice doesn't take over. And this is the games people play with themselves in order not to take action. And the first game they play with themselves is they have to recreate the opportunity. They have to reinvent the wheel. This is one of the biggest ones. I see most new people. This is why it's so important. When you get a new person, you got to get with them within 24 hours. You know why? If you don't, they start to think. And when they think, it paralyzes them. And I know that sounds kind of condescending, don't think, but I really mean don't think. We got to get people taking action. And if you don't get with a new person right away, like for example, Jenny just brought in a brand new person. Jenny needs to get with this person right away to figure out, okay, if this person is motivated to take action. If she doesn't, instead of listening, these people, a lot of new people think they know everything. And you know what they know? All they know is what they've done. And they try to take what they've done and apply it here. Because don't you agree? All people know is what they know. So you got to always represent yourself as the expert and give people the right direction. And sometimes we don't want to do this because we think we're going to step on somebody's toes. Jeff, you're too direct. I love that one when people say that to me. You're too direct. Can you soften it up? No, I'm here. I'm a businessman that's chosen network marketing as a vehicle to get wealthy. And I know that I know. And I need you to know that I know, and I'm here to give you the right direction. And I don't want you, and I don't say this, but I don't want them to think. I don't want them to start to try to create a new scheme or a new system. This is another one that keeps people paralyzed, okay? You get somebody, you're so excited, okay, to sign somebody up or to bring a new person in. and they start to tell you what they want to do, knowing that has nothing to do with our program. And you know what we say? That sounds good. That sounds no. It's there's no new scheme or new system. Okay, we're gonna put billboards up. Oh, that sounds good. I don't put billboards up. We're gonna put billboards all over the highways. Oh, that sounds really good. No, I don't see that in the three steps. Okay, doesn't say step one, put a billboard up. It says follow some very simple things, because a lot of people will get involved and they'll try to design a new system. Now, here's a big one. Some people with network marketing experience bring what they think they know over here. This is what I try to do. Can I tell you a quick story? When we first got involved here, how many times have you guys heard me say this? If I wasn't in someone's living room or doing a hotel meeting 6 days a week, I wasn't making money. So guess what the first thing Lisa and I did when we got involved with World Global Network? After we left Florida and spent 2 days with Fabio, we came home and we called the local hotel and we said, we're going to do a meeting. We're going to do a meeting because that's all we knew. And then we did a meeting, okay, and then what happened was, okay, when I called Jeremy, I said, we have a meeting scheduled. He said, well, that's not really the model here. Okay, the model is to get people information. You don't have to do meetings. But I went to right into what was comfortable. And after one meeting, I figured out very quickly, that's not how we're going to build this. And I simply went right back into what they were telling me to do. I had to get my hands around this. I had to get my hands around the speed. See, even myself and Lisa went back to what was comfortable. Let's do a meeting. No, you've heard it. We've done only 9 live meetings in 10 months. That's not the system. Because what happens when you start to reinvent the wheel, you're wasting time and energy. But really, you know what it is? It's convincing yourself you're actually doing something. If you're reinventing the wheel, you're not doing anything to grow your business. Why would you question, okay, a system that's producing the results that a lot of people are getting? Why would you do that? Because what you're really doing at this point, guys, you're overcomplicating this. You're overcomplicating the business. And here's the reason why. The biggest fear when someone gets involved is to go out there and talk to people. And if you're reinventing the wheel, it's an excuse not to get in front of people. Let's just call it what it is. Because if I have to go out there and do these things, it means I have to reach out to people. I got to put myself in a position to hear a no. And I don't want people to think bad about what I'm doing. And this is, so let me ask everybody here. This is now it's the come to Jesus meeting, right? How many people, okay, are in number one? Be honest to yourself. Don't answer to me right now. Okay, how many people have gotten to this step where you're reinventing the wheel? Okay, I just told you I did. Okay, so now that you've identified it, you got to get out of it. There's nothing to reinvent here. It really is following some very simple steps and being consistent with those steps. Okay, now that you've identified for yourself, now, if you're leading a group, do you have anybody out there that you believe is reinventing the wheel? They need a phone call. Doesn't mean you're gonna, it just needs a phone call from you to let them know, okay, what you're doing, okay, and you don't tell them, you don't call them up to beat them up. Okay, the call I would make is, you know what, Anne Marie, I just heard this training, okay, and they were talking about reinventing the wheel. And, you know, I identified for myself, even Lisa and I, that we got into this step. Okay, and I would do it that way through a third party that you've identified, knowing that's where they are. And you'd like to help them get out of what you know without a doubt is not working. Okay, this is how you do it. You don't beat your people up, because I believe people will do what they want to do. The reason I'm doing this training is because, look it, there's 112 people on. You obviously want this. Right? I'm not talking to the people that aren't on this call. I'm talking to the people that are on the call that say to me every day, I want this to work. Okay? Then let's identify why you may not be getting the results you want to get. And this is a big one. Don't redo the slides. Don't redo the PowerPoints. Don't redo the 2-minute video. I love that one. Okay? We got to change that 2-minute video. Really? Now, why do you think people do that? So they don't have to get in front of people and they could justify the results they're not getting. Period. Number two. Okay? The way you get out of reinventing the wheel is follow this simple system. This is it. And I know you've seen it 10,000 times, and I know some of you will probably roll your eyes at this, but that's okay. It's getting eyes on the video. Okay, but I want you to open up with a real simple question. Do you keep your business options open? Do you keep your money-making activities open? Okay, you got to ask that question. Then when you get an affirmative, a yes, get them the information. And then be very diligent in your follow-up. Let them know, I will follow up with you now. I will follow up with you the day after. If I ask somebody to watch a 2-minute video and they say they're going to watch it, I'm going to follow up immediately in 3 minutes. If they say they'll watch it tomorrow, I'll call them tomorrow night. If someone gets on a webinar and you've taken, I don't know how long to get this one person to receive the information, you got to follow up that same night. Don't think you're bothering people. Well, I can't call them now because it's 9 o'clock and it was an hour and 15 minute webinar. It's 10:15 there. It's too late. No, call them right after. I'm telling you, you establish yourself as a person that's serious. What message does that send if you call 3 days later? It shows that you have no urgency. I'm a business person. I'm building my company, and I want to know if you want to join my company's team. That's going 1,000 miles an hour. So that's how you get out of number one. Number two, inconsistency. This is a killer. We get you all pumped up, you get all excited after you make your decision, and you're hot and cold. And you're only hot when something re-excites you. I talked about that in the opening. Okay, well, we got this product coming up. Oh, I'm excited. We changed a 2-minute video. I'm excited. Inconsistency is a killer, guys. How many of you are dabbling rather than committing? If it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it doesn't. You know why some people dabble? Because they don't want to be held accountable, okay, for their actions. That would be a commitment. And now, if it doesn't work, I could only look within. But if I'm just dabbling, I could blame other outside sources for the reason I'm not getting the results I want to get. You guys, you can't play games with me. I've played them with myself for 24 years. I get it. I know why things work and things don't work. Excited one day, you're excited for 1 week, you're excited for 1 month. Okay, man, the analogies with inconsistency and working out is unbelievable with this business. It's the same thing. I want to get in shape. I'm joining the health club, and I go one day. How much results do you get? I go for 1 week. I don't care if you go for a month. What kind of results do you get in 1 month? You know what you're going to get in 1 month? Pain. That's what you're going to get in 1 month. Lots of it. And then you're going to sit on the scale and go, oh my gosh, I'm busting my butt and I lost 3 pounds and it's been 1 month. You know what you say? It's not worth it. And you know what most people do at the point of 1 month of going to the club without the results they wanted to get because it was an unrealistic expectation? You know what the results are? I quit. That's the result. I'm on this unbelievable diet for 1 month. And Marie Osmond tells me I'm going to lose 50 pounds with Nutrisystems, and I lost 5. And what do most people do? Quit. Well, that's the same thing here. With inconsistency and not a long-term plan with realistic expectations. If you do this for 1 day, 1 week, and 1 month without consistent effort and a commitment, you'll quit. If you're brand new on the business right now, listen to me. Stop what you're doing and listen very carefully. If you don't follow the plan and stay consistent, within 30, 60, 90 days, you will be out of here. Oh, that's too harsh, Jeff, to tell a new person. Really? You know what I used to tell people joining the health club for the first time? You're going to hate this. This will be your worst nightmare. Your first week will be hell week. Because your body is going to be screaming. Okay, because they're taking this pain of exercise as a sign, okay, that this exercise thing is not for you. And I tell people, I want them to have expectations. Listen, I want you to go out there and make a list, and some people on your list are not going to be wildly excited about you talking to them about multi-level marketing. Set up the expectations. You're going to hear some no's. So what? You got to let people know. If being wealthy was easy, okay, we'd all be rich, right? These are the steps that you have to take to get to where you want to go. And this is why I say, you guys, you have to have fun with this. To commit to something, you got to have fun. This can't be like something that you dread every single day. No consistent schedule or plan. Okay, so let me tell you how I help people with consistency. You got to put together your hours of operation. You guys have heard me say this. Okay, if you're going to commit to this, how often? If you had anything else in your life, you'd have a plan, correct? Do you know why you're committed to whatever it is you do? They've given you a plan. If you're an employee, they've given you a plan. Even if you're a business owner, don't you have hours of operation? Okay, what are your hours of operation here? If I ask most people their hours of operation, you know, they say, whenever I get around to it. Well, guess what their paycheck is? Inconsistent. Put together your plan. How many days a week are you going to commit to this? How many hours a day? What hours are you going to be in recruitment mode? What hours are you going to be in training mode? What hours are you going to commit to for webinars? It's a commitment. Okay, I'm talking about people that want to build this thing. If you just want to dabble, right, and open up your contact base to your leader, great. That's a good first step. But I'm talking about getting beyond that. I'm talking about people go, I want to get to $10,000 a week. Okay, I want to get to that president level. Okay, that doesn't happen without a commitment, guys. A consistent schedule that you can hold to. That's the beautiful part of this. See, if I'm sitting down with Dennis, and Dennis says to me, Jeff, I want to make $25,000 a month. Okay, Dennis, sounds great, and I'll write that down. $25,000 a month. Okay, what's your commitment? Let's talk about your list. Let's talk about your plan. Well, you know what, Jeff? I just want to kind of do this every now and again. Okay, maybe I'll do this a couple of days a week. You know, I'll lead you to some people. Now, is that a realistic business plan for him to make $25,000 a month? Are you kidding me? We got to dial this back, my brother. That's what I say. We got to dial this way back. Okay. Now, if you're willing just to do what you just told me, we could probably get you to an extra $2,000 a month. But if you want to commit, see, it's all based on what they want to give you. Now, could he go come out of the chutes and get one good person left and one good person right and get to $25,000 a month? Yes. But good luck with that plan. Good luck with that plan to get two people, one on your left, one on your right, that are two superstars. Okay? Has it happened? Sure it has, but that can't be your plan. The plan is, Dennis, we got to get 40 people in the system in a very short period of time to get momentum so you got two power legs. Now, that's all based on what? Let's talk about your list, Dennis. Let's talk about your credibility with your list. Let's talk about your ability to get these people the information. See, guys, listen, if you have credibility in a contact base, you're ahead of the pack because you have credibility in a contact base. If you don't, you got to get the credibility. You know how you get credibility with people? I'm going to tell you right now. Consistency. People seeing you are sincere about what you're doing. The biggest message we send to people is you're really not serious about this, and they know it. But if they see you having a plan, it may not be today, but maybe 30, 60, 90 days from now, okay, they start to see you in a different light because they see the consistency. Think about the message you send to your group and people that are watching. I want everybody to answer this. What does your group see? What do the people around you see? And what do they think of when they think of World Global Network? Do they think you're serious? Or do you think you're dabbling? What do you think the people think about Lisa and I when it comes to World? Do you think people would say, well, they're serious about it? You think they would say, well, they're not consistent? What would you think? If you said Jeff Giamalva right now, what would you think? Would you think inconsistent or consistent? And I'm not patting myself on the back. I'm just talking about the message. Okay, what message do you send? Gotta look yourself in the mirror and say, okay, now I get it. I gotta make this change. I gotta make sure that everybody knows that I am serious about this journey. I do believe that this is the next big thing. Because that is something I will tell you, okay, it's going to define you in this business. Number three, take rejection personally. This is emotionally crippling. This will make you lose your nerve. This will make you doubt yourself. Rejection will devastate you. It'll stop you in your tracks. Taking rejection personally. Nothing people do is because of you. Got to remember that. Nothing people do is because of you. It has nothing to do with you. It has everything to do, okay, with them. So I never take a no personally. I understand why people say no. I understand some people never get through fear and doubt. In fact, I know everybody in the world would love something that we offer. Then why would they say no? Do you really think they're saying no to you? No. You got to buy into this, guys. Because if you take every no personally, you won't last 30 hours, let alone 30, 60, 90 days. You don't care if people say no to you. It has nothing to do with you. And by the way, you're going to hear the no's. But what do they say? Every no puts you one step closer to a yes. Are you willing to collect decisions? That's it. Collect decisions. But you got to be very good at the questions you're asking people. That's it. And you know why these questions stop people in their tracks? Because we don't have these types of conversations with most people. Think about the conversations you have with most people. What do you talk about? Just really think about it. Hey, how's it going? What's up? Oh, same old, same old. Oh, it's nice out today. It's cold out today. It's hot today. Okay, we never get into real conversations. Listen, do you keep your business options open outside of what you do? Whoa. Okay, now let's open up a conversation and then get those people the information very quickly. So how many of you have taken rejection personally? Okay, who hasn't, right? Now that you know has nothing to do with you, don't take it personally, so now it doesn't have any effect on you. Doesn't make a difference. Okay. Some of us cower in a corner when we hear a no. Really? Justify inactivity, number four. Justifying why you do what you do. Some people start defending the bad results. Well, here's why. Okay, I'm getting the results I'm getting. All the reasons why. And basically, it's because of poor planning and time wasters. It really goes back to number one, recreating the wheel. That's inactivity, is recreating the wheel. Because how many of you have been busy being busy? Ah, man, I really worked hard today. I'm busy being busy. Okay, but if I asked you how many people did you actually touch today, right, and ask that question to, well, no, I was busy doing this. I was busy doing that. I was buying my whiteboard, okay? I was getting my pens ready, okay? All these crazy things, all the games we play with ourselves, just remember, if you want your efforts duplicated, you better make sure they're worth duplicating. And here's a question I always ask people all the time. If everybody in your group did what you did last week, would you be rich or would you be broke? Don't answer to me, answer to yourself. If everybody in your group did exactly what you did last week, would you be rich or would you be broke? Then you're probably duplicating what you're doing. And if that could cut both ways. Some of you say, I'd be stinking rich. Because I reached out to 200 people, I signed up 7. Well, if you had everybody touch 200 people and sign up 7, you'd be stinking rich, right? But some of you, okay, the activity equals productivity. So that's number four. So what are the activities you need to commit to? Now, this is a full training, this just this slide, but just to go through it. These are the critical activities. These are money-making activities. Number one, activity of your accountability. This is your schedule. Being accountable to the activity you said you're going to do today. So let me ask you all a question. What's your plan today when this call's over? What's your plan? How are you going to reach people? That's our job. Our job is to reach people. Now, being accountable to that plan, that's what I'm talking about. And I don't care what the number is. Just be accountable to your number of people you need to touch today, right? Remember, collect 100 answers to that question as fast as you can. 100 people to answer the question, do you keep your business options open? Just try it. Just go through it. Number two, okay, just knowing the features of your product. Don't spend too much time on this one. The features of the product is what's on the 2-minute video. Critical activities, as soon as you can. 5 team developers left, 5 team developers right. This is as soon as you get your, obviously, team builder. If you're brand new, your first step, get to team builder today. Get your first 2. Then you get to team developer. But if you want to build the right structure, right, for president or above, 5 team developers left, 5 team developers right. And the only way you get that is to know and have your activity of accountability. Good way of doing your five TDs left and five TDs right, get the 100 answers to that question. You're going to get 10 yeses. You're going to get people wanting the information. That's all you're asking for. Keeping your head right with a good reading and listening library. These are critical activities. This is a good activity that a lot of you participate in every day. Okay, Diamond Zone. This will get your head right. Okay, this will stop you for at least an hour to really focus in on your world global network business. But you know what I always recommend? Reading one chapter a day in a personal development book. You know why? Because that allows you to understand why people are different than other people. They've committed to the right activities consistently. Showing the plan. This goes back to number one. The only thing we could do is show the plan. Now, when I say show the plan, showing the plan was a lot different, okay, before World Global Network. Showing the plan was what I said in people's living rooms or hotel meetings. Showing the plan here is getting people the information through the web. 2 minute, 7 minute, comp plan. 2 minute, 7 minute, webinar. 2 minute, 7 minute, three-way call. 2 minute, 7 minute, one-on-one. It's whatever that is, you're leading people through the system. That's it. Okay, step one, join the health club. Step two, get your measurements. I'd write down all the measurements. Step three, go through your first workout. And step four, repeat. That's it. That's what it is. Well, that's our steps over here too. 2 minute, 7 minute, whatever's next. Webinar, one-on-one, collect a decision. Then next, go through it again. Same thing, every day. Every day, nothing changes. Edification, okay? Edifying your leadership. Letting people know that they're involved with the right people and the right system. Do you know who your upline is, everybody on this call? Your plugged in upline. Do you know who your plugged in upline is? Do you know their backgrounds? Well, we do know who's on top of everybody, for sure, is Chad and Natita and Nat and Shanita. Have you ever talked about them when you talk to people, about the people in your upline, edifying them? Edifying the system, edifying the company. Because if you don't have the credibility in your mind with the person, then edify the people you're involved with. You know why that's important? Because a lot of people you're talking to know you're brand new. But if they know you've aligned yourself with people with years of experience, I'm telling you, it gives them more confidence maybe to receive your information. Okay, so that's what edification is. Here's another thing. If you want to be held accountable, seek counseling, seek mentorship. And I'm not saying just because you want to, it's to hold yourself accountable. It's not just to be part of the popular club. Okay, it's about knowing, wanting to know what you're doing on a daily basis is right and being held accountable. Okay, there's a handful of people. I could count on maybe 10 of people we work very closely with because they're committed. They call me more than I call them. That's when you know you have a committed person. They want the mentorship. Promoting your tools and events. Okay, well, we know the next one, right? Las Vegas. We've never missed a company event. These are critical activities for your business, guys. Number five, listen to the dream stealers. When you're collecting decisions, when you're talking to people, has anybody here come across a dream stealer? You know what a dream stealer is? These are the people that are going to make you doubt your opportunity. These people sometimes, come on, be honest, aren't they venomous? Aren't some people just mean? and they start to tell you how crazy you are, and they would never do multi-level, and what's the name of your company? Did you see what's on the internet? I've seen some of your reviews, and they keep going at you, and they make you doubt your opportunity. Make you question your beliefs, doubt yourself. Here's what you have to understand about a dream stealer. Because I've never met a successful person ever in 24 years. I'm talking about a financially successful person ever try to steal my dream. They're encouraging. They may not do it, but they encourage you. So what you have to understand, here's what I do. If I come across a dream stealer, automatically, you should go right to this slide and just understand the loudest critics are usually the ones angry and frustrated about their own lives. Their venom to you is really speaking to themselves. Just know that. These are the games you play with yourself. But you know what a lot of people do when they hit a dream stealer? Oh, where is that? What was that article you read? What website was that you saw? And the product didn't work? And we start to buy into what they're telling us. And those things will never work. You know, there's a reason why a lot of people, okay, never ventured into technology. It's very difficult. It'll never work. Have you guys heard this kind of stuff? If you haven't, you haven't talked to enough people. That's for sure. Okay? If you talk to enough people, you're going to come across the dream stealers. But this is where you go back to your why. Why are you doing this? And it keeps you moving forward. Don't take this personally. Now, how do you get past the dream stealers? How do you never let them steal your dream? Knowing what you have to offer. And I'm not going to do this. I know you guys roll your eyes every time you see this, but I don't care. Okay? Because this is what you're offering people. So every day, you know what I want to do? I want you to sell yourself on what you're doing and what you're offering. This is really what you're offering people. And I want your belief big. Who doesn't believe on this call that people out there want something on this slide? Who doesn't want something on this slide? Think about it. This is what you're offering. See, we think we're offering this. This is the widget. This is the widget. Is it a good widget? It's the best widget I've seen in 24 years. Why? Because it's a category creator. But a lot of you talk too much about this. This is all you talk about. Heart rates and blood pressures and blood glucose and studies and the Infolio phone. Is that stuff good? Yes. But sometimes we create our own objections. You're talking more about what's coming versus what we have. And tell me if I'm not right. How many of you have heard this? Well, then I'll wait till that comes out. How many heads are shaking right now? You've created your own objection. You gave them the objection. You gave them the softball to hit. Talk about what you do have. I talked very little about this. You know what I want to talk about? Okay, you want to change your financial situation. Haven't you always wanted to own your own business? Let's talk about your situation. What would it mean for you to cover your car payment, a mortgage payment? What would it mean for you to be paid what you're worth? Let's talk about your retirement. You've done what you've done, John, for 30 years. If you lost your day job tomorrow, John, can I just ask you a simple question? If you lost your day job tomorrow, John, how long could you keep your same standard of living? We don't have these conversations, do we? Why don't you start having them? Well, are you kidding? I couldn't go 2 weeks. You need residual income, John. That's why I'm talking to you. That's why I asked you the question. Do you keep your business options open outside of what you do? I found something. And I'm aligning myself with a team of people with a proven system for success. Have I talked about the Hilo yet? And I'm not talking about not to say anything about the Hilo. Of course you're going to say something about wearable tech. Of course you're going to talk about category creator. But you've got to get off of it. Because you start talking about everything, and most of you talk about things we don't even have yet. What's coming? And then you give them the softball to hit when they say, well, you're right. I can't wait for it to come out. Let's talk about that when the blood glucose comes out. All right. Now what? What do I say now? I don't know what you say now. I can't even help you there. Okay. What do you say now? You go back to what the reason is they go to work every day. That's what you say now. I'm going to go off camera here for a second so I don't go, I don't lose the signal. Okay. Why do people go to work every day? Because they love the product their company offers? I don't think so. I don't think so. I think people go to work every day for money. That's what I think. I think I was loyal to Bally Health Clubs because they paid me. That's why. And if someone offered me double the money, I'd be out there promoting that company, providing it was ethical. So this is what you're offering. This is how, okay, you get past the dream stealers. You need to be sold on what you're really offering people. This is what you're offering. This is what gets people to move. Some of you are looking how to close people. Stop talking about just the features of the product and talk about the features of the business. And that's how you get people to move. Because people understand one thing, money. They know they need it. They know they want it. And they know they don't have enough of it. And I'm going to talk about that. This is how I'm going to get people to make a decision quickly, outside of everything else that's coming. Okay, now, number six, become a crybaby. Oh, I'm going, I got 6 minutes. Okay, endless complaints, emotional demands, always talking about the problems. They don't produce, they don't take direction. They don't commit, they don't honor the program. And basically, there's nothing you could do for these types of people other than building the business for them. There's some people I call, every time they call me, you guys have this, right? This little device. How many of you have a caller ID? We all do now, right? Can I tell you what I do with some people who call me all the time? I look at it, I see the name, you know what I do? I reject it. I put it down. You know why? Because I know whatever that person calls, all it is complaints, emotional demands, and telling us everything that's wrong. I got to protect this. I protect Jeff every day. These are not your garbage cans. We know the issues. We all know issues. Everybody has issues. Every company has issues. I'm not looking, okay, for the person always pointing out everything wrong. Now, obviously that cuts both ways. Obviously, if something is wrong, don't you think we know about it? Of course we do. But I'm looking for people that want to help and figure out the solutions. I understand some people, I like how some people handle it. Listen, are you aware of this concern? Are you aware of this is happening? Perfect. Just want to make you aware of it. Now, let me tell you what's going on with my business. I'm so excited. I plan on talking to 20 people today. I'm doing LinkedIn now. That's how you handle it. Believe me, we know. And if you live here, guys, once again, you're going to have a short lifespan here. Because the very reason you got involved was to be a pioneer. Well, what comes with being a pioneer are dealing with the challenges that we're all going to go through, every single one of us. And the biggest challenge is dealing with ourselves. Okay, number seven, fearful of wrong things. These are all the things you guys understand. Fear of failure, fear of change, fear of the unknown, fear of what others think makes you willing to settle for less. Fearful of wrong things. Guys, fear of failure, what's failure? The only failure in my mind is quitting. You can't fail if you keep doing it. Even if you're hearing all no's, you're not failing. Do you know when you're hearing a series of no's, you're successful? You got to turn this. A no is success. A no isn't failure. Hearing no yeses or no's is failure. It means you're not doing anything. And don't worry what other people think. The day you stop caring what other people think is the day you start to become wealthy. Period. I don't care what you think. I'm going to tell you what I think. And that's established me as a belief system. Okay? This is where you got to get to, guys. And number eight. Okay, premature full time. All right. I hit this one. Okay, some of you get off to a good start, and because you want to leave your day job so bad, okay, you say, I'm quitting. That'll put a lot of pressure on yourself if you're not making consistent income. Now, most of you are not even near this, but I know some of you have thought about it. Because you're going to lose your previous income, and in most cases, you lose daily contact with your warm market. Because whatever you've done, those are the people you hung around. If you remove yourself from there, okay, just know this. How are you under pressure? That's all. How are you under pressure? I happen to be good under pressure. I'm only really good when my back is against the wall. That's why I said the day we made this work in multi-level, okay, a lot of you've heard this, when the severance package was spent, when the credit cards were maxed, when the home equity line was gone, is when I finally went to work. Truth. I just didn't get involved in multi-level and go, I'm just going to start making this work. No, I had to deplete everything. Okay, now I'm not suggesting that because that was not good. Okay, that was just my laziness kicking in. And as long as I had money to pull from, I didn't really take this seriously. In other words, as long as my bills were being paid, why would I go to work and really commit? That's the truth. That's the truth. Every credit card was maxed, the severance package was spent, the home equity line was gone. That's when I went to work. Now, I'm not saying this, but I do say this. And you guys heard me say this before. If you want to take this seriously, pick something that has to be paid with this business. Pick something. Don't just say, I want to make $10,000 a month. Okay? Start this way. Take your car payment out and say, I have to cover this car payment this month with the money I earn with World Global Network. See if you don't work differently. And here's the caveat to that. It doesn't get paid unless it comes from here. Because let's just face it, if you have bills right now and you're not getting enough money coming in, doesn't some bills, don't you juggle? Don't you play the shell game? Then why would this be different? Okay, do you want to cover a mortgage payment? What is it? $2,500 a month? $5,000 a month? California, $10,000 a month? Okay, $20,000 a month? Has to be paid from here. This is how you hold yourself accountable. And that's exactly what Lisa did. And I'll close with this. Lisa didn't talk about money. She talked about things she wanted to cover. When she first got involved, it was the grocery bill, $1,000 a month. Then it became the grocery bill and one car payment. This is how she did it. Then it became the grocery bill and both car payments. Then after 6 months, it was the grocery bill, both car payments, and the mortgage. Then it became retiring and replacing my income. And that was after 2 years. After 6 months, she was covering the mortgage and both car payments. After a year, it was $10,000 a month. But she held herself accountable. She goes, I just want to start knocking off these bills. And that's what drove her, right, to make sure she was doing her daily activities. Otherwise, if there's no motivation, guess what we all do? Let's just be honest with each other. Nothing. It's amazing how everything gets in the way of this. But that job that's not paying us what we want, we never miss a day. And we'll go to work sick, coughing, sneezing, but you know what? I'm not missing. But over here, go out there and get 100 decisions. Ask that question. Get 100 people and then lead them to the information. Promote tonight's call. Okay? So that's your pitfalls, guys. I went long, 1 hour today. So happy Monday. Let's have a great week. Look forward to seeing everybody tomorrow and on tonight's call. Love you guys. Talk to you all soon. Bye. Woo. Everybody wave to each other. All right. End meeting. Oh, look at all the pretty faces. There's my girl, Elf.